May I start by complimenting Meat and Livestock Australia on their Australia Day TV advertisement? So, I loved it. First question. In your letter to me dated 27th of October 2021, Mr. Strong, you acknowledge the data I quoted in the last Senate estimates from a report published on the CSIRO website titled Australian Cattle Herd, A New Perspective on Structure, Performance and Production dated 2021 was correctly quoted. I thank you for that and accept Meat and Livestock Australia consider the figure I used is higher than you would use. The lead author of that report, Dr. Geoffrey Fordyce, works for Meat and Livestock Australia on your NB2 herd pillar feed-based program. Is that correct?
It certainly has. I'm not sure if he's currently contracted senator, but certainly he has worked with us, yes.
Definitely. Okay. So my decision to use that data that I used was logical then, wasn't it?
Partially, Senator. Yes.
Thank you. So turning to Meat and Livestock Strategic Plan 2025. You're familiar with that. On page 4, this is in your own words, Mr. Strong. With a whole of industry strategic plan in place, Red Meat 2030, that's the name of your plan, there is an opportunity for Meat and Livestock Australia to drive transformational change. We have to find ways to support the industry to deliver on its ambitious vision of doubling the value of red meat sales. That's the end of the quote. Could you please specify what percentage of this 100% increase in sales revenue will come from price rises and what percentage will come from sales volume increases?
Thank you, Senator. The Red Meat 2030 plan is actually the industry plan that was put together by ARMAC. It's a 10-year plan that the industry collectively put together. Our five-year plan then fits behind that, and we've adopted the same overarching goal and the six pillars. That's our five-year plan, and it draws on the Red Meat 2030 plan, which is the broader industry plan. It doesn't specify what component of that growth comes from price or volume, and it's probably speaking from an opinion being involved in that process, but the setting of that target was to be ambitious for the future of the industry in creating and capturing value, but also making sure that we weren't, as an industry, limited to price or volume. And the industry over the last 30 years collectively has invested in a significant range of activities, not just with Meat and Livestock Australia and our R&D and marketing, but in a range of other activities as well, for us to produce a higher quality, more consistent, traceable, guaranteed product, but also taking advantage of or participating in the preferential market access that we also have available to us as well. So there's opportunities for us to increase productivity, but there's also opportunities for us to create and capture more value in higher quality products with where we have preferential access to high quality markets. So it's a combination of both, Senator. Well,
pardon me, but it sounds like waffle. Because who are you trying to convince here? Because the farmers, surely, the producers, need to have some kind of faith in what you're leading. And yet you're telling me now it's just an ambitious plan with no limit on price or volume. So surely this has all been modelled.
So there's a number of things sitting behind it, Senator, but I think it's quite the opposite to waffle. It's providing opportunity in multiple areas rather than restricting it to one.
So hang on. Opportunity comes from knowing something about it. What you're saying is here, we haven't done this. It's an opportunity because it hasn't been modelled.
Senator, the opportunity comes from the investments that the broader industry's made over the last 20 or 30 years in having a consistent quality traceable product with a quality assurance program behind it that is being sold at higher prices into markets where we now have preferential access.
So I accept that, but you're still talking very generally, because to double the value of red meat sales, you need to increase the price. You need to double the price if the herd stays flat.
If the volume stays the same. So the volume can increase if the herd stays the same size. You can have increased carcass weight or increased productivity.
13% your increased carcass weight.
Yep.
Doesn't seem to be any real meat in this.
Senator, there's an outcomes report. Oh, sorry.
You could try to play, but you're never gonna beat me. Look the other way, what I'm doing ain't easy. Bloody hands stained from the people who deceive me. Muddy hands break through the chains, go free me.